Jerry Seltzer's roller derby story begins with his father, Leo, who created the sport.
Leo Seltzer had a lease on a building in Chicago, the Chicago Coliseum, and he had to fill it with people, so he started with marathon walks and runs and big charts of the United States, walking across the United States. And one day he thought of and made up the game of roller derby, and that's how it started. And Jerry brought it to the Bay Area in 1960 and started the Bay Bombers here at that time.
Jerry Seltzer worked hard to popularize roller derby as a legitimate sport.
Jerry's biggest contribution was doing what people said he couldn't do. His first season, KTVU was the television, and he was doing his live television game out of the training school at 86th Avenue. It held like 400 people. And then the following year in 1962, he went to Kezar Pavilion, where he stayed until we closed out in 1973. And he kept growing and growing, and people said, yeah, but it's roller derby. It's not going to do anything. And even sports writers here in the Bay Area said, Jerry, you're getting your head ahead of yourself. You have to remember, we skated six nights a week. And as a business promotion, he called it the Bay Bombers, not the San Francisco Bay Bombers or Oakland. It encompassed the entire Bay Area, so everybody was a part of it. And he would play San Francisco on Sunday, live television, San Jose on Monday, be off on Tuesday. Wednesday, we'd be in Stockton or Lodi.
And you guys were televised all over the country.
And right? We went all over. And Saturday nights, we were at the Oakland Auditorium. They didn't have the Coliseum yet.
At its peak, the league was broadcast in 120 television stations across the U.S. and Canada, and filled arenas from Madison Square Garden to the Oakland Coliseum. Seltzer left the league in 1973 as its final owner and co-founded Bay Area Seating Service Tickets, or BASS Tickets, and a decade later went on to become vice president of sales and marketing for LA-based Ticketmaster until 1993. It was with Bass that he began to become interested in charity.
He was a very charitable guy. He did a lot of good charity things. But one thing he did with Bass was we would get promoters and arenas and the Giants and everybody to give us... A promoter hates to have an empty seat in the house. So they would give us any tickets they had left over. Jerry then accumulated about 40 or 50 charities of the Bay Area, and we would then transfer the tickets to them. The Bass people would show up and show them to their seats. This was one of his great charitable events.
Seltzer returned to the Bay Area and joined popular luxury footwear line Bonjour Fleurette as its marketing and sales director and COO. He lent his considerable expertise to Brown Paper Tickets, co-founded the Sonoma Valley Film Festival, and volunteered as a consultant to emerging amateur roller derby leagues. Jerry was greatly looking forward to his induction, but sadly, he succumbed to pulmonary fibrosis just months before the ceremony. Thus, he was inducted posthumously.